Judith-Anne made her own decisions. Anyway, she's always been impossible to control, all those fights and arguments. Well, she'd have the whole house in an uproar, and it's not fair on Rom.
He'd love to see her back, he told me.
He's always been a soft touch. You know that as well as I do. But his own health hasn't been the best. You can't disrupt the whole household for the sake of one person.
But what about the baby?
Well, I'm prepared to help it financially.
If your daughter's not good enough to live in your house, I'm sure she wouldn't want your money. And I don't either. Your money or your room.
Well, I'm sorry you feel that way, Mum.
So am I.
If you're going to lock someone up in the pound for no reason, you could at least make sure they're fed and let out on time. What's up with this place?
There's a strike.
I figured that had to be it.
But I still wouldn't try anything if I were you.
You know, I reckon if Fletch keeps up this record, he won't even be here when Mrs. Davidson gets back.
You could be right for once.
It's true, she's agreeing with me. I think I'll change my mind.
There's only one problem, Smith. Mrs. Davidson won't be coming back.
She's resigned. And with Mr. Fletcher out of the race, guess who's next in line for the governor's job?
G'day.
Bee.
I wouldn't get too excited, Coulson. Your friend's bound to be back in solitary in a day or two.
Well, I'm glad you're out. They should never have locked you in there.
Yeah, it's second home to me.
Pat, isn't it?
Well, Pat, what's been going on while I've been cooped up in the pound?
We've been cooped up in here.
Yeah, what are the screws on strike for?
Who knows? More money, probably.
Oh, I think there's more to it than that. One of them, Jackson, acted quite funny when Chrissie and I came in.
Ah, yeah, Chrissie Latham. She killed Mrs. Jackson's husband.
Oh. How did you know she was in here?
Lizzie's been keeping me informed. She's a dab hand at smuggling the notes and the mashed potato. Messy, but readable.
Yeah, I bet poor old Meg's a bit upset at seeing Chrissie again. Funny, though. I would have thought it'd take more than that for the screws, just to walk out.
Meanwhile, we're left to rot in here.
At least it gives us a chance to get to know one another.
Pat was convicted for helping her own husband and son.
Oh, yeah. Aiding and abetting, eh? How much longer you got to go?
She's hoping to be out by Christmas time.
I want to be with my kids for the holidays. I reckon if I play my cards right, I can get paroled by then.
Do you know, they even told her she had to get a divorce so she'd get paroled.
Oh, you two have got to know each other pretty well.
There hasn't been much to do but talk.
Hey,
ah, g'day, Lizzie. How's it going?
How are we
going to
get out of here?
You got any good ideas, Phil?
When we set fire to our mattresses, they'll have to let us out.
Oh, don't be a dill. Can you see Vera running around trying to save us? By the time she'd unlocked all the doors, we'd be barbecued.
Well, what are we going to do then, Dee?
Nothing. Nothing. Just sit here and wait.
Hello?
Mrs. Jackson?
Yes?
It's Jim Fletcher here.
Look, I don't think I've really got anything...
Please. I won't take up much of your time. It was my responsibility to check the Latham file, and, well, I didn't.
I already know that.
Well, I just want to say that I'm sorry. I would never have given you the order to admit her if I'd known.
No. Perhaps you wouldn't have. Well, apologies accepted, but it doesn't really solve anything, does it?
Look, I'll make sure that you're never rostered on her wing and that she's allocated to the workshop. She'll be kept out of your way at all times.
Thanks, that would help. But I don't think the other officers will accept it.
They dislike me that much, eh?
It's not so much dislike, it's more resentment. If you'd listen properly to our complaints instead of treating us like a bunch of stupid women, you'd have a better idea of why we're on strike. You just don't understand the problems.
And Mrs. Davidson does.
Well, on the whole, yes.
Why is that, Mrs. Jackson? Just because she's a woman? I see. Do all the other officers feel the same way?
I think so.
Thanks, Mrs. Jackson.
Excuse me, is Major Linwood in?
Yes, he is.
Oh, that's me. Can I help you?
Good afternoon. My name is Erica Davidson. I was speaking to an acquaintance of mine, Angela Jeffries.
Oh, the lovely Miss Jeffries. Yes, a charming woman. She's been a great help to us in the past.
She said she'd received a list of missing persons from
her. That's right. I send her one every month. Well, she has a lot of contacts, you see, and there's always a chance she might come across someone on the list.
Well, that's why I'm here. I understand you're looking for Doreen Anderson.
Doreen Anderson. Now, let me see. Oh, yes, here we are. Doreen May Anderson. Oh, yes, that's right. It's a bit strange. Her mother wants to find her, but she doesn't want to contact her.
Why not?
Well, I've no idea. She hasn't seen her for 20 years. Still, it takes all kinds, doesn't it? You think you may know this girl?
Well, obviously, I need more than a name. But the girl I'm thinking of is an inmate of Wentworth Detention Center.
Oh, dear. And you?
I'm the governor of Wentworth. What concerns me is that Doreen is a very insecure girl who dotes on the memory of her mother. If it's a case of mistaken identity, or worse, if it is her mother and she is rejected by her, it won't do Doreen very much good at all.
Oh, I see, of course. Well, naturally, we always check these things out before making contact.
Well, perhaps if you could give me her mother's address.
Well, I'm afraid we don't use
Doreen is still officially my responsibility. She's due for parole soon, and I would like to do what I can to help her.
Well, yes, of course, of course. Well, perhaps if you'd like to step into my office, we can chat about it there.
Thank you.
Oh, look, would you send that to Captain Riley, please?
Yes, certainly, ma'am.
That won't be long.
Yes, sir. Sit down, please, Mr.
All right, now, Mr. Fletcher, what's the situation with the strike? No, it can't go on indefinitely, you know.
I think they resent me being in charge, sir.
Well, no doubt. I spent all morning speaking with the union representative about the discipline here. They seem to think you're being too harsh.
Well, I don't think it's the restrictions I've laid down, sir. I think it's the fact that they... Well, they resent a man being in charge of a woman's prison.
Well, why the hell don't they say so?
Well, I think they have, sir, but not in so many words.
Mr. Fletcher, the department is more than satisfied with your previous record of service. And we wouldn't have placed you in charge if we weren't confident that you could handle it. But, well, this strike is no good for anyone. So far, we've been able to keep it out of the press, but the longer it goes on, the harder it gets.
Yes, I appreciate that, sir.
I don't want to see your good record spoiled, and I want to give you a fighting chance. But unless your officers are back at work by midday tomorrow, I'm afraid the department will have to be called in.
Yes, sir. I understand.
What's wrong?
I'm not sure. I just had a pain.
Was it a contraction?
Well, I don't think so. I mean, I've had a couple of them before.
When?
One about half an hour ago and another about 5 minutes ago.
They're not regular, then?
No.
Oh, that's all right. It's probably just the baby moving into position. Is he kicking very much?
Like a mule.
Nothing to worry about yet.
Have you had a lot to do with babies?
No, not really. Why?
You just seem to know a lot about it.
And the advantages of being a bookworm.
Karen?
Mm-hmm?
Well, how will I know what the contractions feel like? I mean, I might just think it's the baby kicking until it's too late.
Don't worry, you'll know. Fancy a salad for dinner?
Fine.
How long is this going on? I'm not a flaming waitress.
Look, pipe down, Lizzie. Just think yourself lucky you're allowed out occasionally.
Ah. Mine's always cold by the time I get it anyway.
Now, Connell, dinner. Get moving.
Good evening, Mr. Fletcher. Here, about time you let us out, don't you think? Some of the girls are getting a bit restless.
Yeah, well, there's nothing I can do about that.
Nothing?
Nothing.
And I thought you were the boss.
Come on, get a move on there.
I'm doing my best.
Sounds to me like you're slipping, Mr. Fletcher.
Shut up, Smith. Dinner?
About time, too.
Hey, June, got any good books to read? I'm fed up with that Chrissie rabbiting on. She's mad.
Come on, Lizzie. This is a prison, not a lending library.
Ugh.
B wants to know why the screws are on strike. Any ideas? First time the governor served us dinner. He must have nothing to do.
Come in.
Kitchen supplies.
Thank you.
How's things going?
From bad to worse, thanks to you.
I can't control the way the officers feel.
No, I suppose I was expecting too much to think that my deputy governor had backed me up.
Well, they have got a point. If you push the prisoners too far, it could end up with an officer getting hurt.
Oh, you mean they might try and push one of the officers off the roof?
Are you going?
Yes, I've had enough for tonight. Who's on night duty?
Maguire. I'll go and see if she's signed on yet.
Miss Bennett, do you agree with the other officers that a woman should run Wentworth?
Yes, I do.
Yes, of course you do. Anybody particular in mind?
Damn.
Oh, Mr. Fletcher, this is a surprise.
Yes, I'm sorry to disturb you at home, Mrs. Davidson.
Not at all. Come in.
Thanks. I won't take up too much of your time.
What can I do for you?
Well, actually, it was a bit of advice that I was after.
Oh?
Yes, it's about the strike. I suppose you've heard about it.
Yes, I had heard.
Well, I was wondering if you might have any idea how I could make the officers see reason.
I'm sure they wouldn't strike without reason, Mr. Fletcher. Would you like a drink?
No, thanks.
Have you tried using a little tact?
No, kid glove treatment isn't the answer. The prisoners take advantage of it and the officers are worse off. Anyway, as I understand it, lack of discipline was the reason I was sent to Wentworth in the first place.
We are talking about tact, Mr. Fletcher, not discipline or the lack of it. Anyway, a prison governor is only as effective as her staff will allow her to be. Occasionally, I didn't receive the support for which I'd hoped.
You mean Vera Bennett?
I didn't say that, Mr. Fletcher.
No, you didn't have to. I know what you mean.
Vera is a very ambitious woman. She's dedicated her life to the prison service. One day she'll be a governor.
Well, that day could be sooner than anyone thinks.
Well, that's your decision. It has nothing to do with me.
Then you have resigned?
I haven't confirmed it yet.
But you're going to?
I think so.
Shower?
Yes, it's going a bit far.
Oh, come on, screws! It's bloody unhygienic being cooped up in here.
Let us out!
Mr. Douglas? It's Jim Fletcher here. Yes, sir, I'm sure they'll be back today. Well, I'm prepared to concede some of their demands. No, it's not a case of backing down. I do have a few conditions. Yes, sir. Well, there is another thing. I no longer feel that I can continue on here as governor. Yes, sir, I realize that. But I'd be prepared to stay on as deputy governor. Vera Bennett. Well, no, sir, perhaps not under those circumstances. Yes, I've made my decision. Thank you, sir. Goodbye.
Well, have you got everything packed?
Hmm?
Nighties, underwear, things like that?
Oh, yes, sort of.
Well, you better check and make sure. You better get a number of the taxi, too. We don't want to be leafing through the phone book when the time comes.
It's on a piece of paper in the kitchen. Well, there's plenty of time. He's not due for 4 days yet.
Well, babies that age have no idea of the date. He might decide he's been in there long enough.
If he's anything like my baby brother, he'll decide to stay there a couple of weeks longer.
Still, we have to be prepared.
Well, Gran will be home tomorrow. At least I'll be home to welcome her.
Oh, yes. Do you know what time she gets out of hospital? I'll send a taxi to get her.
Oh, well, there's no need. Dr. Miller's offered to pick her up. Isn't he a nice man? I mean, he just takes such an interest in his patients.
Yes, he certainly does.
He's quite dishy too, isn't he?
Judith-Anne, I'm surprised at you. Any more pains?
Just now and then, but they're not regular.
Well, we'll head for the hospital when they're 20 minutes apart and getting stronger.
Oh, I'll be all right. Don't worry.
Sorry to interrupt your holiday like this, Erica.
Don't worry. I'm getting used to it. Could I get you something? Coffee? Drink?
Oh, no, no. Not for me, thank you. No, I was just wondering if you'd come to any firm decision about your resignation.
Yes, but I haven't confirmed it yet.
Oh. I had rather hoped that you decided against it. Now, Erica, if it's about the McNally business, I've already started a departmental inquiry.
No, it's not that at all. In all the years I've been at Wentworth, I don't seem to have been able to achieve anything. Same faces keep coming back, the same women causing the same trouble, the same wall to knock one's head against.
Well, that's hardly your fault, surely. That's the system itself. Now, you can't be expected to change that single-handed.
Thanks, Ted, but I think I'm the one who's due for the change.
A great pity. You're one of the best governors Wentworth had.
I'm sure you'll find someone else.
Jim Fletcher has resigned, too.
I thought perhaps he would.
He's prepared to stay on as deputy if you come back.
I'm sorry.
Oh, well, I can only hope that he's prepared to work under Vera Bennett. Oh, I'm going to be off.
Has the department decided on who they are appointing, then?
No, Vera's the next in line. She's the most experienced officer available at the moment. I suppose it'll be offered to her.
Do you think she's suitable?
She's not my choice, but there again, it's not up to me.
Well, she won't follow the policies I adopted.
Well, of course not. But I think her forthright attitude will carry weight with the appointments committee.
There'll be trouble with the women.
Oh, bound to be. Bennett's never struck me as being overly sympathetic toward inmates. Erica, I wonder if I could have that drink now.
Yes, of course. What would you like?
Oh, whiskey would be fine. Oh, it's been a difficult week. I suppose it'll settle down eventually. Pity we're losing you, though. It's amazing the faith the departmental hierarchy place in the governor's recommendations. Thank you. Although I don't see Vera Bennett suggesting too many changes. Couple of paroles coming up next week. Unlucky for them. Still, you win a few, you lose a few, eh?
Good morning, ladies. Ready for another day in Mr. Fletcher's circus?
Morning. Everything back to normal?
Practically. B. Smith's been released. The women are to get their privileges back. And Chrissie Latham's to work in the workshop. She'll be kept out of your way as much as possible, Meg.
I hope so.
Miss Knox, you'll take D block. Miss Meadows, the maternity wing. And Miss Watson, you supervise the workshop. And make sure Chrissie Latham doesn't wander in and out as she pleases.
And where am I to go, Miss Bennett?
Look, Meg, I'm sorry about what happened.
I bet you are. I wouldn't be surprised if you planned this strike from the start.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. Of course I wouldn't.
At least you could have warned me about Chrissie Latham.
I'm really sorry. But anyway, it's turned out for the best. Jim's resigned, and when I take over, I'll make it up to you.
You seem to be counting your unhatched chickens.
Miss Bennett, Mr. Fletcher.
Hello. Yes, Mr. Fletcher. Certainly. I'll come at once. It looks like those chickens are just about to be hatched.
Thank you.
supermarket shopping these days is more like the charge of the light brigade.
It's awful, isn't it?
What are you doing?
I think it's time. Well, the pain's been coming every 15 minutes.
Why didn't you say something? I'll phone the ambulance. I mean, the taxi. Dad. Up!
Where are you going? I just want to leave a note for Gran.
You sit down. Just sit down. Sit. Oh. I'm going to call the taxi. Now, where's the number?
In the kitchen.
Okay. All right. Now, you just stay there and wait until the taxi comes.
Karen, don't panic. There's plenty of time.
It's all right. Just keep calm.
You wanted to see me?
Yes. Come in, please, Miss Bennett. Are all the officers back?
Yes.
Good. Now, I don't know whether you're aware of the conditions that the unions agreed to. One of them is that B. Smith be isolated from the rest of the prisoners as much as possible. She's the main troublemaker. I think if we can segregate her from the rest of the prisoners, we'll have a pretty good chance of controlling them. Put her on guard in detail, will you?
Oh, but that'd suit her down to the ground. Being outside all day, she won't do a scrap of work.
Miss Bennett, I didn't ask for your opinion. That's my order, and it stands. At least until next week, when I shall no longer be in charge. I'll leave Mrs. Davidson to decide what to do with her then.
What's it got to do with her? She's resigned.
Oh, hadn't you heard? She withdrew her resignation. She'll be back next Monday.
You know, I never thought I'd be pleased to see the screws again. But after 3 days in my cell, I could have kissed them.
I'll drink to that.
You'd drink to anything.
Yeah, well, B reckons it was all Fletcher's fault, you know. He's losing control. That's why he had her transferred to the garden so she couldn't cause trouble. Rotten pig. She didn't do nothing.
He probably wanted to protect her from the criminal element in here.
Yeah, well, I think it was a lousy thing to do.
God! There's enough work here to keep us going till Christmas.
Yeah, it's a good thing we've got Roz to give us a hand.
Yeah. That was real good of you to volunteer to come and help us. You didn't have to, you know. Not when you're on remand.
Oh, what else would I have done? If I'd stayed in that cell for one more minute, I'd have gone crazy.
Anderson?
The welfare officer wants to see you.
What for?
Well, if you don't go, you won't find out.
It's probably about my parole. I don't want to go.
Anderson, would you get moving?
Well, don't worry, Dor. The social worker's real nice. She's probably found her a rich sugar daddy.
Yes? Mrs. Hemmings?
Yes.
My name is Erica Davidson. I have some information about your daughter.
Oh. Are you sure she's my Doreen? Won't you come sit down?
Well, I've checked the details you gave the Salvation Army, and they tally with the details I recall on Doreen's file.
Her file?
Yes, I'm the governor of Wentworth Detention Center. I'm afraid Doreen is one of the inmates in my charge.
Oh, no.
I understand you don't want to see her.
No. Especially if she's... I was intending to make out my will and leave everything to her.
Why did you go to the trouble of trying to trace her? You could have left it to your solicitor.
I don't know. I somehow feel responsible.
After 20 years?
I tried to find her. When I left Gordon, I couldn't take her with me. I was penniless. And by the time I'd found a job and could support us both, he'd disappeared and taken Doreen with him.
Didn't you try to get custody?
Of course I did, but the police couldn't find him. I don't know how he managed it, but there was no trace of him. It took me 7 years to get a divorce. By then, I'd met Paul Hemmings. He was such a gentle man, I somehow couldn't bring myself to tell him that I'd deserted my own daughter. And then when he died last year... What's Doreen like?
She's very insecure. She depends too much on other people. Inevitably, they move away. She's alone and insecure again.
What's she in prison for?
Breaking and entering. She also escaped and was involved in a shooting incident in which the woman she was with was killed.
How long is she in for?
Well, she's due for parole soon, but I doubt whether she'll get it. She has no one to go to on the outside.
No, I couldn't.
She needs someone.
I can't.
Well, that's up to you. You know where she is.
What will happen to her?
Well, she could go to the halfway house, but I don't know. I doubt whether they'll be able to help her. She'll probably end up back inside.
What is this halfway house?
It's a refuge for ex-prisoners. Actually, you could do more good by making a donation to them. Doreen needs care, not cash.
Do you think they could help her?
More than Wentworth can. I'll give you Angela Jeffrey's card. You can go to see her. Form your own opinion. My number's on the back if you want to contact me.
Oh, thank you.
Please think about it.
I will.
Goodbye.
Sing, Kath. Let's stay friends.
Singing to rely, rely, Adity. I'm bound for Botany Bay.
You ought to go in for new faces, Kathleen.
Yeah, she needs one.
Oh, what's up, Dor?
They're going to put me up in front of the parole board next week. They're going to kick me out and send me away from all my mates.
Don't worry, love. You mightn't get it.
Yeah, I mean, you've got to have a job and a home to go to, and if you haven't, they're not going to let you go.
Doesn't make much difference. My time's up in a month anyway.
Comes to all of us, love. Might even come to me soon. And when you get out, you've got to face the world, look them straight in the eye, kick them in the teeth before they do it to you.
What's the problem? I can't understand anyone getting upset about getting out of this place.
Me neither.
When you've been here a few years, you begin to look upon it as home.
You're joking?
No. It's just like home, really. I mean, you got no worries. You got a roof over your head, nice warm bed to sleep in, plenty of tucker. Don't have to worry about a job. Do you remember old Edie? She died because she couldn't face loneliness on the outside.
Yeah. I suppose the place has got something going for it.
No.
If I had to stay in here for 50 years, I'd still be glad to get out.
That's what you say now. But if it was me getting out, I'd be upset just like Dor.
But Dor's young. She's got a whole life ahead of her.
Well, you don't have to be old to be lonely.
Yeah, and I've got no friends outside. No family.
Neither have I, Doreen, but I don't want to stay in here forever.
Who needs family? Look at Mum. Her only daughter kicked her out. But she made good, didn't she?
Yeah, I suppose.
Judy! Karen? Well, where are they?
Well, don't panic. They've probably just gone for a walk.
Well, supposing something's gone wrong with the baby.
And supposing it hasn't. Judy's a perfectly healthy girl. Stop worrying yourself like that, you'll end up back in hospital.
Her suitcase is gone.
Here.
She's gone to hospital, says there's nothing to worry about. Karen is fussing like a broody hen. And otherwise, everything's fine.
Hey, see?
Well, I must get to her.
Oh, well, I'll drive you.
Oh, no, Dr. Miller. You've been very kind, but I mustn't keep you from your work any longer.
No, I've plenty of time. Besides, I'm looking after one of my patients.
Well, thank you.
Oh, were we on time? Is she all right?
Of course she's fine.
Everything's all right.
Yes. Calm down. Are you her sister?
No, I'm just a friend. Well, I think I'll tell Mum.
Her mother?
No, her grandmother. Judy lives with her.
Is she the next of kin?
Yes. Well, no. Why?
It's all right. Just a formality. Relax. Nothing will happen for a couple of hours yet.
No. I'm sorry, I haven't heard. Oh, Erica. Come in. I won't be a second.
Look, I'm sorry about that.
Yes. Well, look, I'll ring you when I know. Okay, bye.
I hope you don't mind. The door was open.
Oh, not at all. Sit down.
You're a very busy lady. I've been trying to phone you.
Oh, the phone hasn't stopped all day.
I thought you'd like to know. I've decided to return to Wentworth.
That's great. You can do so much good out there.
Perhaps.
Well, the halfway house is coming along. You should see it. It is full of plumbers and carpenters and builders.
When will it be ready?
Well, I should think a couple of weeks. I've already got some women interested in moving in.
I may have someone else for you.
Oh?
Doreen Anderson.
Oh, yes. Did you find anything out about her mother?
I've just been to see her. A woman with a very guilty conscience, but not guilty enough to take Doreen in.
What do you mean?
Well, I don't think she deliberately deserted Doreen, just a victim of circumstance. But she's left it a few years too late to start feeling remorseful.
Why does she want to see her now?
She says she wants to leave her estate to her, but I think it's more to it than that. I told her about the halfway house and took the liberty of giving her your card. And she seems to be quite well off. She may make a donation.
Oh, all contributions gratefully received. Poor Doreen. She needs our help more than ever now, doesn't she?
She needs someone to take an interest in her.
A mother's interest is better than anything.
Yes, but Alice Hemmings positively refuses to have anything to do with her.
Hello, Dor. Want a game?
No.
Oh, come on. We want a four.
Where's Bea?
She's in a cell. She's feeling a bit crook after digging in the garden all day.
Yeah, she said she didn't feel like playing.
Me neither.
What's with her?
She's worried about going out on parole.
I'd give my eye teeth to be shot at this place.
Oh, come on, Kath, it's not so bad in here. Especially if you haven't got anyone on the outside.
Yeah. Hi, Doreen. Take a pew.
Huh?
Sit down.
Thanks. Nice to be able to watch TV again, isn't it? Yeah, great.
Doreen, Pat and I were thinking of taking up a hobby.
Yes, just to pass the time. Rug making. I used to do some at Barnhurst. Ever done it?
No.
We were going to ask the governor for the materials.
Why don't you help us?
No. It's no point. They'll be kicking me out of here in a few weeks.
Why did they tell me to leave? It must be getting close.
They'll let you know as soon as it arrives, Mum.
Well, it's taking so long. I think I'll just go and see if there's any more news.
You talk about expectant fathers.
Well, it is her first great-grandchild.
Yes, I know. Mind you, you were doing a fair bit of pacing when we first arrived.
I haven't had much to do with babies.
How's the halfway house?
Oh, fine. My room's ready now. I should be able to move in soon. We'll be able to take guests in a couple of weeks, despite the paint and mess.
Good. Things have worked out pretty well for you, haven't they?
If you mean I'll be out of Angela's clutches, yes.
That's not what I meant.
Sorry. How's the new surgery?
Oh, I've got a long way to go yet, but I'm getting there. Mind you, I think I'd be broke now if you hadn't taught me into going back to Wentworth.
How's Doreen?
Fine, as far as I know. Why?
Well, Angela got a letter from the Salvation Army. Apparently her mother's looking for her. Hadn't you heard anything about it?
Yeah, not a thing.
Hello. I'm
Alice Hemmings. Erica Davidson gave me your card. Won't you come in? Thank you.
She told me about this halfway house you're setting up. It's a worthy project, but it's in need of a healthy bank balance, I'm afraid. Won't you sit down?
Thank you.
I may be able to help you a little. My daughter's in Wentworth. She'll be getting out soon.
Oh, I am pleased. You'll be glad to have a home, no doubt.
Oh, no, I haven't seen her since she was little.
Oh?
I've only just found out where she is. I can't see her. I just want to make sure she has somewhere to go when she gets out.
Well, obviously, we'll do all we can to help ex-prisoners. But that's no substitute for a real family.
I know, but I can't get involved with her. I mean, for her sake, it wouldn't work.
It's a pity.
Have you ever been to Wentworth?
Several times.
You don't know Doreen, do you?
No, but a friend of mine, Karen Travers, does. Why?
Oh, I'd like to know what she's like.
Well, there's no harm in visiting.
Well, I can't see her. She mustn't know about me.
If you're interested, I have an idea.
This waiting is the worst of all.
Don't worry. He'll be here soon.
Oh, definitely a he, is it?
Definitely. The firstborn in our family for three generations has been a girl. It's time the cycle was broken. And Daniel's the one to do it.
It might be Danielle.
He won't be. I know. I knew with Lorraine and her children. Even stuck in Wentworth, I knew. Lorraine didn't even write and tell me about Benjamin. Ron did. But I knew all the same.
You'll be reading Palms and Teacups next.
I don't think so. But it would be nice to know what the future's going to be. Funny, it's Lorraine I feel sorry for. She thinks she's cutting us off, but really she's only cutting herself off from her own grandchild.
Hey, come on. No more depressing thoughts. You'll be back in a hospital bed yourself soon.
Mrs. Brooks?
Yes?
Congratulations. You have a grandson.
Oh, oh
that's
right.
Wonderful.
I tell you.
Lovely.
Are they all right? Can I see them?
Yes, come with me.
Isn't it marvellous?
I'll give you a lift home after you've seen her, Mum. You still need to rest, you know.
Yes, all right. Thank goodness that's over.
Yes, indeed.
Greg, are you busy tomorrow? Do you have any spare time?
A little. Why?
Do you think you could take me to see Lorraine?
Well, what for?
What I think she should know about the baby.
And you think we should tell her?
Well, nobody else is going to. She still thinks of me as an ex-crim. I think you'd make a good impression.
All right. Well, I'll pick you up when I finish at the prison. I'm only in for an hour or so tomorrow.
Morning.
Good morning. Hi, Meg. Morning, Ted. I was at the maternity hospital yesterday. Judy had a boy.
That's terrific. How is she?
Oh, no problems at all.
And the baby?
Fit and healthy, all 3,250 grams of him.
What's that in English?
Oh, about £7.4.
Gee, I bet Mum's pleased. She always said it would be a boy. Daniel, isn't it?
Yes, that's right. Should have seen her last night, wearing holes in the waiting room carpet.
Oh, poor Mum.
Well, Karen was just as bad. We're going to see Judy's mother a bit later. You never know. We might even persuade her to visit Judy.
You never know. Well, I must get her some flowers.
So you'll be going to the hospital then?
Try keeping me away. Oh, I know I'm supposed to be old and sick, but I've had a good night's rest and I feel quite capable.
Yes, I guess you are. You will be all right.
I take it by that you're not coming.
No, Greg and I are going out.
Oh, well, I'll be as right as rain. Don't you worry. Dr. Miller's a lovely man, isn't he? And he seems to be interested in you.
Oh, Mum.
You could do far worse for yourself.
You know, you and Judith-Anne are birds of a feather. I won't tell you what she said about him.
It's a pity I can't get in touch with Lorraine. But her mother died a long time ago. She told me so herself. Oh, well, I'll ring Ron at the office. He can handle it. Daniel Ronald Watkins.
my great-grandson. Take that.
Good, Mrs. Barry, do we have to be watched all the time?
Governor's orders.
Yeah, puts me off having someone watch me all the time.
Don't exaggerate, Leech.
Bloody Fletch. He's getting too big for his boots.
Oh, it's gone to his head being the governor.
Yeah, I can't wait till Mrs. Davidson's leaves up.
Mrs. Davidson's resigned.
What?
Yeah, he told me. That's right, isn't it, Mrs. Barry?
Just Smith to get her facts wrong. Mrs. Davidson will be back next Monday.
Oh, cool. Did you hear that, girls? Davo will be back next week.
Doesn't make no difference. She's the same as all of them. Just start getting friendly and they shoot through.
I wouldn't do that, Doreen. We could be friends.
What's the point? We'll be getting out of here soon.
Well, so will I. We can meet on the outside.
You reckon you'll get off?
Of course I will. Tony McNally shot my mother. Everybody knew that. I just did their job for them.
Hmm. Well, you won't want to see me.
Yes, I will. I haven't got any friends in Melbourne either.
Oh, Lizzie, I've got a message for you.
What are you doing here, O'Connell? You're not rostered for the laundry.
Oh, I just had to see Lizzie for a
second. Come on, out.
B says Judy's had the kid, a boy.
Who told her?
Dr. Miller.
O'Connell.
Oh, just going.
Hear that door? Judith-Anne's had the baby.
Oh, gee, that means Mum's a great-grandmother. What was it?
A boy.
Who's Judith-Anne?
Oh, she's Mum's granddaughter. Mum was in here for years and years and years, and when she got out, well, her daughter wouldn't have nothing to do with her. And now she's got a real nice flat with Judy.
See? Things can work out well for people.
Yeah, if you got someone. But I ain't got no one.
Oh, it's you.
Mrs. Watkins, this is Dr. Miller. He's been looking after your mother.
Look, I went to see her because you made me feel guilty. But it didn't do any good.
Your mother's out of hospital now, Mrs. Watkins.
And what are you doing here? Don't worry, you'll get paid.
We've come about Judy.
I told Mum I will not have that ungrateful little... I won't have her in my house.
She is your daughter.
Yes, so everyone keeps telling me.
You also have a grandchild.
So she's had it then.
Boy.
How is she?
They're both doing well.
She's named him Daniel.
Little bitch. That was my father's name.
Judy would love to see you.
Oh, yes, I'm sure she would. No, she's made her bed, she can lie in it. With whoever she likes. Look, I have to go.
So you won't come and see them then?
No. Look, I'll give them whatever financial help they need, but I won't have them in my house.
What kind of mother is that?
There's a visitor for you, Doreen.
Well, there must be some mistake. I never get no visitors.
It's no mistake.
Perhaps it's that friend of Tony's come to see you again.
Come along.
I hope it's something good, poor kid. She deserves a break.
Who is it, Mrs. Jackson?
I honestly don't know, Doreen. One of the other officers checked her in. I was just sent to get you.
Who are you?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again, but that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down, but the sun and rain are prisoners too. Around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the when morning comes around.